Morning everyone, welcome to our science class. Okay, so today we are going to be learn about class 7 science. Okay, so in this video lesson we are going to discuss about your science book, that is chapter number 7. Okay, so what we are going to discuss in chapter 7, that is your weather, climate and elements. Okay, so our today's topic is weather, climate and adaptation. Okay student, so let's discuss one by one. First weather, then we will discuss about the climate. Okay, after that we will come to discuss about the adaptation of animals and plants. Okay, so first weather. Okay, so now this is rainy season running off. Okay, so whenever you watching your television, okay, or even if you, I don't think you are going to listen for radio, but whenever you are watching television at the news channels, various news channels, the weather report will be published, okay? And the weather report will be changed day by day, because weather is a situation of the environment that will be changed after hour and hour and after minute and minute also, okay? So, now we are going to really learn about the weather. Okay. Okay, student. So here we discuss just a comparison discussion between the weather and climate. Many students assume that the weather and climate are the two same thing. They are not different. Okay, but they are in between them there is huge difference between the your weather and climate. Let's I will discuss with you as a comparison view in between the weather and climate. And I also discuss that how much different from one another. Okay, so let's first discuss about the weather, then comparatively we will discuss about with climate. Okay, what that is weather? Weather is an atmospheric condition of a place on the earth on daily basis. Okay, so what is that? It is an atmospheric condition. Okay, so whenever we watch in our whenever we watch television on a news channel, that weather report that will be published at the morning time, that will be also published at the evening time. Okay, so here the weather that tell weather report tell us what will be happen in our next day, what will be going to be happen there today. Okay, what will be the condition of the atmosphere? That means it will be raining today, or it will, what is the temperature for the today? Okay, if any snowfall will be occurred at anywhere, okay, and then what percent will be the raining or the rain or the precipitation percent will be gone today? Okay, so all these type of, and what will be the percentage of humidity in the atmosphere? Okay, so weather report is a atmospheric report. It will be tell us about what type of environment or what type of atmosphere will be going to be had on today. Okay, so weather report will tell us about the atmospheric condition of a place on the earth on a daily basis. Okay, so the weather does not deal with the whole area, okay, or the whole country. It deals with a small area, just like a district or state. Okay, as a result, we got the actual report for the weather. Okay, so it is small area or on a small or certain places that for suppose in our area at a certain time, whenever the rain will be occurred in our Odisha, then there will be very sunny day go for in case of Delhi or Mumbai. So we cannot say today will be rain for all over the India. Okay, so weather that tells a report of a very small specific area. Okay, that will be present on our earth, and it will be tell on the daily basis. Okay, so what will be going for today, what will be going at the next day. Okay, so weather forecast will be published on the daily basis and deals with a small region. Okay, but as a comparison view of climate details of the average atmospheric pressure. It does not tell the exact value. Okay, it deals with the average a large region over a prolonged period of time. Okay, that means the climate will be deals with a suppose it may cover a whole country, okay, and it does not mean that it totally rainy or totally sunny. It gives a average report. Here the weather gives the exact report, but in case of climate, we got an average atmospheric condition, okay. And whenever the weather deals with a small place, okay, small place that may be a city also, but in case of climate, we go for a longer, well, large region. Country basis, okay, and it works on a daily basis. That maybe change day by day, but it will be work for a prolonged period of time. That means it will work for a long period of time. That may be 20 or 30 years. Okay, after that, it change day by day. Okay, or maybe hour by hour. If the hour can be the rain time your 12 a.m., then after 12 a.m. it may go for a sunny day. Weather in the change by day and day, or there may be change after hour or hour, but the climate will be remain unchanged. Okay, the climate of a certain region will be stable. After the weather is assigned to a small area, that may be a city, or that may be a district, or that may be your state. So, the weather report forecast and deal with a very small area. Okay, but in case of climate, it deals with a very large area. For a total area, for a total country. Suppose the climate of India, the climate of Jammu and Kashmir, okay, the climate of Canada. Okay, so it deals with a total, maybe sometimes the whole state, or there may be deals with sometimes the whole country, but the weather deals with some state, district, okay, town. Okay, so what will be included in case of weather? Weather includes temperature, rainfall, humidity. Okay, these are the main components. Which deals with the weather. But whatever climate, climate also deals with this thing, but it deals with the average temperature, average rainfall, and average humidity. Okay? So, may I hope you have clearly understand about the your weather and climate. Okay? So, whenever we go for climate, we discuss about more thing on climate, according to the geographical view of Jammu and Kashmir, we call that the Jammu and Kashmir is a snowy area, and Bengaluru is a humid climate, and Chennai also got a humid climate, and Kashmir that a snowy climate, okay, and your Cherrapunji that has a rainy climate. Okay, so by observing them for a long period of time, we can assume that here the Bengaluru at that place is humid, that humidity also be high, so we call the Bengaluru is a humid climate, and Jammu and Kashmir that snowfall will be occurred a longer period of time, so we call them the Jammu and Kashmir is a snowy climate. Okay, so all by observing for a long period of time, we assign some region or some places as a certain. Okay, so student, here we know something about the weather and climate. Okay, so let's discuss one topic, that how do rotation and revolution of earth affect weather and climate. We are going to study for the weather and climate of the earth. Okay, so we know one thing, that earth always rotate around the moments and revolve and make the revolution around the sun. Okay, so how the rotation and the revolution of the earth that makes up effect, that may totally affect on the weather and climate of the earth. Okay, student, suppose here your sun, okay, and here your mother earth will be revolve around the sun in a certain distance of elliptical orbit. Okay, so suppose here is our earth. Okay, so earth always rotate around its axis. Okay, suppose here if this is the earth. Okay, suppose it is our mother earth. Okay, just here elliptical is orange like that. Imagine a line that will be separate the earth into two semicircular, two hemicircular, then this called the x. Okay, so R that always rotate around this axis. Okay, this will be called the R that will be always rotate around its axis. Okay, so this will be called the rotation of the R. Okay, so the rotation of the R. So how much time will be taken by the R to complete one rotation? Okay, so that you will take 24 hours. Okay, so that complete one. Then we consider why we take one day as 24 hours, because R takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Okay, suppose here is U. The R also rotate. U present at R, so U also rotate along with R. So this portion is moved just like here and come to the same position. Okay, so to come to the same position, R takes 24 hours. That means to complete one rotation about its axis, R takes 24 hours. Okay, so this may cause for the rotation of R that cause for the use day and night. Okay, so how, so why in the arc we observe day and night? Due to the rotation of arc around its axis, we feel day and night. Okay, student, so why this sunlight will be formed on this way? Okay, so those portion which face towards the sun, that capture the sunlight and they feel this portion as a daytime. Okay, and behind this portion, those are left over, they don't get sunlight and at that time they feel night. Okay, after that, when the arm will be rotated, that this portion comes to this side, so they feel the daytime, and this portion goes to downside, so they feel night at that moment. Okay, so why we observe day and night? Because R always rotate around axis, so at a half of day we feel, so half of one day we feel day and half of one day we feel the night. Okay, student, after that, here the R not always rotate about one axis, it also reform around the okay, so the R that will be that complete one rotation or the complete one revolution around the sun, it takes 365 and 1/4 day. Okay, it takes total complete 365 and 1/4 day. As a result, this 1/4 causes a leap year after the completion of 4 years. Suppose in year after, just like 2016, and this year also 2020. Okay, and after 2024, this year possesses 29 days in the month of February. Okay, and here also 29 days in the month of February. But in case of 2021, that will become next year, they may possess 28 days in the month of February. So this one day will be increased by this 1/4 day. Okay, so R there to complete one revolution around the sun, it takes 365 and 1/4 of a day. Okay, so what will happen in case of this revolution? Okay, so let's discuss this. Portion temperate zone. Okay, so this is about the rotation and revolution of the earth. The rotation of earth causes the day and night, and the revolution of earth causes the season changes on the ground. Okay, it will be clear about how the rotation and the revolution of earth effect on weather and climate. So student, now we complete the discussion about the weather and climate. Now I am to discuss about the adaptation. Okay, so here first discuss during the climate is recognized some region that this is snowy climate. Suppose the Jammu Kashmir got the snowy climate and the Chennai got the humid climate. Okay, in this way, according to the observation around this region, we may classify that this is the climate. Okay. So according to the climate, during the different climate, different animals are being presented here. Okay. So now we discuss about the climatic adaptation of the animal. Okay. According to the climate, some animals adjust themselves according to the climate. Okay. So that will be called your adaptation. Okay. Now we discuss completely about the climatic adaptation of the animal. Okay. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about two things. Suppose this is our earth, and these two portions are called the pole. Okay. So the top pole, this is your north pole, and this is your south pole. Okay. So we are going to be discuss about the climatic adaptation of the animal who are living the polar region and the animals who are living the this your tropical forest zone. Okay, we are going to discuss about two things, that is the effect of the climate and the adaptation of the living animals living in the polar region and the tropical region and which type of and which country are becomes under the tropical rainforest region. Okay, so the in the polar region, the country just like your Canada, Alaska, Finland, Greenland and Siberia and the whole Antarctic continent. Okay, Antarctic, about the seven continent, Antarctic is a continent which is totally covered with the snowy region, and that also belongs to the polar region. Okay, except the Antarctic region, some of that your Canada, Alaska, Finland, Greenland and Siberia are belong to the polar region, and the tropical rainforest will include your India, then your Brazil, Kenya, Malaysia and Indonesia. These are the country which are comes under the tropical rainforest region. Okay, so we are going to discuss about the climatic adaptation of the animal in the polar region and also the tropical rainforest region. Okay, so let's first discuss about the polar region. Okay, so the climatic adaptation of animal, we are going to be learn about these two things, that is one is polar region and another is your tropical rainforest. First learn about the polar region. Here two poles are there on the topmost portion of the earth, the north pole and the south pole. The north pole also got the Antarctic region and the south pole also got the your Arctic region. Okay, so in the during the inclination of the earth around this 23.5 degrees Celsius, okay, so this causes the less sunlight fall on these two poles. So about 6 months observed as your winter season, and next 6 months go for the summer season. Okay, and this 6 months also go for the day, your just like your day, and 6 months will continue for the night. Okay, so about the lowest temperature in the Antarctic region is, that is your minus your competing research. Okay, so the maximum temperature in the Antarctic zone is minus 30 degrees Celsius and the lowest temperature of the Antarctic zone is minus 39 degrees Celsius. So we can, how we can imagine at that portion is most cold. Okay, so what type of animals will be survive right there? Okay, but in case of Arctic region is quite warmer as compared to Antarctic region. The lowest temperature is minus 40 degrees Celsius and the highest temperature is your 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, so around this Arctic regions at some places, okay, and the sea coast area, some animals are also live and some cities also be present here. Okay, so now discuss about the what type of animals are we present at this region or the animals like in the polar region. Okay, so due to the very coldest region, it will be due to the less amount of sunlight that will fall in these two regions. So these two portions are cold, snow covered. Okay, and the very so these two portions are totally covered with snow. So very less vegetation will be there. So very less amount of animals are we able to survive in those portions. Suppose the animal just like your polar bear, penguin, seal, whale, your reindeer, musk ox, and woolers are the few wildlife animals that will be live in this region. Okay, so now discuss one by one how their body will be adjusted in this region. Now first let's discuss about the polar bear. Okay, the animal or the bear which will live in the polar region are called as the polar bear, and they are found in Alaska, Canada, Greenland and the other Arctic country. In the Arctic here there is snow almost entire year, so they not stay on one place. They travel across the snow looking for food. Sometimes they swim for far into the sea. Okay, so now discuss about the adaptation of the surviving in the cold. Here this two region fully covered with snow, so we easily imagine that they are very cold all around the year. So what are the adaptation quality for the surviving in this cold? Okay, first that is adaptation. Adaptation means some special feature or habit that will be induced or that will be produced by the living organism that may be placed in such a region to adjust at that place is called your adaptation. Okay, so the development of the special feature and habit is called the adaptation. Okay, so what will be the special feature that will be developed by the polar bear to survive in this much cold region? That is that first one is it has a too thick layer of fur keep it warm on land. Okay, so the polar bear possesses too thick layer that will be made with fur. Okay, this layer of fur that will help to protect it from the severe cold. Okay, after that it has a long hair in between the pads on the feet that helps to keep it warm and walk on ice. After next one is it has a thick layer of fat called bubbler under the skin that keep it warm while swimming in ice cold. Okay, ice or cold water. After that we will discuss about the adaptation for hunting prey and protection from predator. Okay, there will be some adaptation will be occurred in the case of polar bear to hunt the prey and prepare their food, and that also help to save from the predators. Okay, so the general color of polar bear is white, as this two portion that will be present of snow, that also the background is also be white. So the white color of the polar bear and also helps to your camouflage against the snow. Okay, camouflage means it will be totally mixed with the surface. As a result, the his prey, the his prey will be not recognize the polar bear. As a result, it will be easily catch the prey and feed it. Okay. After that, okay, there will be 5 very sharp claw on the each foot, and for grasping, grasping the ice and its prey. Okay. So it has 5 sharp claw on his foot that also helps to capture the food and easily kill that. Okay. Next, it is a very, it can smell its prey for a large distance. It has a very developed your olfactory loop that help to smell, that help to recognize its prey by smelling after a long distance. Okay. Next one is the polar bear huge teeth helps to tearing its prey apart. Okay. The polar bear possesses a very sharp teeth. With the help of this teeth, it can easily tear the flesh of the animal, its food or the its prey. Okay. Next, to adaptation for staying in water. Okay. So mainly, whenever this snow will be melted, then it will form the icy water. Okay. So it will be also be also the it has required to pass the time, okay, in this snowy region, also the cold water. So what will be the adaptation or what will be changes will be occur in case of polar bear to sustain in this environment? That is the first, it has a streamlined body that helps to swim. Okay, the streamlined body structure just like your fish and birds. Okay, polar bear also possesses a streamlined structure that has to swim in the water. It has no much barrier by the water to swimming. Okay, as a result, as the position of the streamlined structure, polar bear make swim in the sea water or this icy water for a longer distance. Okay, next, the polar bear has a stiff fur on its front leg and very broad front teeth feet to help it to swim. After that, the hind legs and the are held flat are used for rubbers. It can close its nostril and remain underwater for a long period of time. Okay, so this is the adaptation by the polar bear that able to survive in the colder region and also helps into the staying in water for a longer time and also help is to hunting prey and protection from the predator. Okay, now another animal, that is your penguin. Okay, penguin also live in this region, in the your Arctic and Antarctic region or the polar region. The penguin is also belong to the your family of the birds, okay, or aves, but the penguin have not a capability to fly. Okay, it has a developed quality that it can be able to swim inside the water for a longer distance and for the longer time. Okay, so most penguin live in the Antarctic and also along of the southern coast of Africa, Australia and the around of New Zealand. Okay. Penguin is a unique as the penguin pair cell duty. Okay, so during the lifetime of the penguin, this the couple of the penguin, they share their duty. Whenever the female lay the egg, then the male has the egg, and that time female will be go for the preying and they catch the food and they collect the food. After sometimes the duty will be changed. The female will hatch the egg, and the male will go for the hatching, and male will be go for the collection of the food. In this way, they share the duty of the your caretaking of their baby. Okay. Okay, students. So remaining portion of this chapter we will be going to discuss in our next class. Here we are going to discuss. We will discuss about the weather, climate, and the adaptation of the polar region. That we only discuss about the polar bear. Next. The adaptation of the tropical forest region animals will be discussed in our next class. Thank you so much.